The San Andreas Fault is a geological wonder that stretches for approximately 800 miles, 1,290 kilometers, through California, from the Gulf of California in the south to Cape Mendocino in the north. It is one of the most famous fault lines in the world and is responsible for some of the largest earthquakes in California's history, including the 1906 San Francisco earthquake, which had a magnitude of 7.8. At its core, the San Andreas Fault is a tectonic plate boundary between the North American plate and the Pacific plate. These two massive plates meet at the fault line, which is characterized by a complex network of smaller faults and fractures. The North American plate is a massive piece of the Earth's crust that covers most of North America and parts of the Atlantic and Arctic oceans. The Pacific plate is similarly large and covers most of the Pacific Ocean, as well as parts of Asia and the western United States. The San Andreas Fault is what is known as a transform fault, which means that the two plates are sliding past each other horizontally. This movement occurs because the two plates are moving in different directions. The North American plate is moving south, while the Pacific plate is moving north. This motion creates a great deal of stress and pressure along the fault line, which is released in the form of earthquakes. The San Andreas Fault is responsible for approximately 10% of all earthquakes in California, and scientists estimate that there is a 30% chance of a major earthquake, magnitude 7.5 or greater, occurring along the fault line in the next 30 years. Despite its reputation as a highly active fault, the San Andreas Fault is actually relatively quiet in some areas. For example, the southern section of the fault line, which runs from the Salton Sea to the San Gabriel Mountains, has not experienced a major earthquake in over 300 years. This has led some experts to suggest that the southern section of the fault line may be locked, which means that the two plates are not sliding past each other and are instead building up pressure. If this is the case, it could mean that the southern section of the San Andreas Fault is overdue for a major earthquake. Scientists are using cutting-edge technology to study the San Andreas Fault and better understand its behavior. For example, GPS monitoring can track the movement of the plates in real time, while seismometers can detect even the smallest earthquakes. Studying the San Andreas Fault is important not just for understanding the geology of California, but also for mitigating the risks associated with earthquakes. California is home to millions of people and is one of the largest economies in the world, so earthquakes along the San Andreas Fault could have significant consequences for both people and businesses. In conclusion, the San Andreas Fault is a fascinating and complex geological feature that serves as a tectonic plate boundary between the North American plate and the Pacific plate. Its history of seismic activity and potential for future earthquakes make it an important area of study for scientists and a critical consideration for those living and working in California. The San Andreas Fault is a tectonic plate boundary between the North American plate and the Pacific plate that stretches for approximately 800 miles, 1,290 kilometers, through California. This fault line is one of the most famous in the world, and is responsible for some of the largest earthquakes in California's history, including the devastating 1906 San Francisco earthquake. The San Andreas Fault's 800-mile stretch is a complex network of smaller faults and fractures that runs from the Gulf of California in the south to Cape Mendocino in the north. This vast expanse of the fault line traverses a wide variety of landscapes, from the arid deserts of Southern California to the rugged coastline of the north. One of the most striking features of the San Andreas Fault's 800-mile stretch is the Carrizo Plain. This area of central California is home to a wide range of geologic formations, including the Temblor Range, the Elkhorn Scarp, and Soda Lake. The Carrizo Plain is also home to a number of endangered species, such as the San Joaquin Kit Fox and the California Condor. Another notable feature of the San Andreas Fault is the Coachella Valley. This region of Southern California is known for its hot, dry climate and its abundance of golf courses and resorts. However, the Coachella Valley is also home to a number of geologic formations, such as the San Jacinto Mountains and the Indio Hills. In addition to these geologic wonders, the San Andreas Fault's 800-mile stretch is also home to a number of cities and towns, including Los Angeles, San Francisco, and Sacramento. These urban areas are home to millions of people, and are some of the largest and most important cities in the United States. Unfortunately, the San Andreas Fault's 800-mile stretch is also one of the most seismically active regions in the world. The fault line is responsible for approximately 10% of all earthquakes in California, and scientists estimate that there is a 30% chance of a major earthquake, magnitude 7.5 or greater, occurring along the fault line in the next 30 years. This seismic activity has significant consequences for those living and working in California. Earthquakes along the San Andreas Fault can cause extensive damage to buildings and infrastructure, disrupt transportation and commerce, and lead to loss of life and injury. To better understand the San Andreas Fault's 800-mile stretch and mitigate the risks associated with earthquakes, scientists are using a variety of techniques, including GPS monitoring and seismometers. These tools allow scientists to track the movement of the plates in real time and detect even the smallest earthquakes. In conclusion, the San Andreas Fault's 800-mile stretch is a vast and complex region that traverses a wide variety of landscapes and is home to millions of people. While this region is rich in natural wonders and cultural treasures, it is also one of the most seismically active regions in the world, and earthquakes along the fault line can have significant consequences for California and beyond. By studying the San Andreas Fault and preparing for future earthquakes, we can better understand this amazing geological feature and help ensure the safety and well-being of those living and working in California. The San Andreas Fault is one of the most well-known and studied fault lines in the world. It stretches approximately 800 miles through California and is responsible for some of the largest earthquakes in the state's history. Despite its reputation as a highly active fault, there are some areas where the San Andreas Fault is relatively quiet, leading experts to suggest that it may be overdue for a large earthquake. To understand why some experts believe that the San Andreas Fault is overdue for a big earthquake, it's important to first understand how the fault works. The San Andreas Fault is a transform fault, which means that it occurs at a boundary between two tectonic plates. In this case, the North American plate and the Pacific plate are rubbing against each other, causing a buildup of stress along the fault line. When the stress becomes too great, the rocks along the fault line break and shift, causing an earthquake. This process is known as an earthquake cycle, and it typically occurs over a period of decades or even centuries. One of the reasons why some experts believe that the San Andreas Fault is overdue for a big earthquake is that there are some areas where the fault line has not experienced a major earthquake in a long time. For example, the southern section of the fault line, which runs from the Salton Sea to Parkfield, has not experienced a major earthquake since 1857, when the Fort Tejon earthquake struck with a magnitude of 7.9. Similarly, the northern section of the fault line, which runs from San Francisco to Cape Mendocino, has not experienced a major earthquake since 1906, when the San Francisco earthquake struck with a magnitude of 7.8.